The sound of chisels can be heard all over Inami. Famous for Inami wood carving, this town is referred to as the home of wood carving. Its history is closely linked to the history of the area who have a strong religious faith. Zuisenji Temple, which was first constructed 600 years ago, has been rebuilt several times because of disastrous fires. In 1763, as a result of one fire, the temple was rebuilt with the help of the master builder, Shibata Shihanchiro. His team of carpenters and carvers were dispatched from Higashi Honganji Temple in Kyoto. They were joined by carpenters from Inami, who had been bestowed land by the Kaga clan. It was at this time that some carpenters started to learn advanced carving techniques. This work, entitled Shishi no Kotoshi, is by Shichi Zaimon, the ninth generation master carpenter of the Bonjoya workshop who had been bestowed land. It represents the origin of Inami wood carving. After the completion of the main building, Mayakawa Sanshiro, the carver who had taught Shichi Zaimon, was suddenly summoned back to Kyoto. Despite this unexpected turn of events, the reconstruction work continued uninterrupted. Iwakura Rahachi, a carver from the Kongojia workshop, is said to have been only 17 years old when he carved the Kaya Rumata lintel carvings on the temple gate. The young carvers were obviously sufficiently skilled to take over the work from the master carvers. This sutra desk and box is outstanding work that dates from the latter half of the Edo period. It shows the level of refinement in the carving techniques that took root in Inami and were passed down through the generations. However, at that time, there were only about 5 people who had made their living as wood carvers. Most of them worked mainly as carpenters and broadened the range of techniques and styles used in shrine and temple carvings as an occupation on the side. Yohochiro Morisada, the 12th generation master of the Bonjoya, worked full-time as a sculptor at the beginning of the Meiji period and subsequently trained the 5 apprentices who became the foundations of the Inami wood carving industry. Later, when construction began on Higashi Honganji Temple, Iwakuru Rihachi was put in charge of the wood carving. Oshima Gon devoted all his energy to the creation of innovative ranma, or transom carvings, for houses that went beyond the scope of shrine and temple carving. He also developed new techniques that had not existed. This ranma, transom carving, represented Japanese craftwork at the San Francisco Expo. Transom carving later evolved using techniques that emphasize an object's three-dimensionality by layering thin materials. In 1932, 18 carvers headed off to Tokyo to work on carvings for Tsukichi Honganji Temple, which was being reconstructed under the direction of Matsui Kakuhei, a descendant of an Inami carpenter who had been bestowed land. Itto Chuta was a leading architect of the time who adopted the Indian style in his original temple designs. These carvers were asked to create designs and to develop carving methods that had not previously existed in traditional carving. Initially, they encountered many difficulties, but by their second year, they had completed both large and small carvings, such as the Kaya Rumata lintel carving in the main building in 85 different places. Later, Itto praised their work, saying that Inami wood carving was the best in Japan. Inami's carvings are made with traditional techniques that have been honed over the generations. Ingenious new techniques that have also been carefully thought out. Inami carvers also have an artistic sense that has been acquired through new experiences. Before long, Inami became known as a town of artistic handicrafts and art. Inami wood carving has been changing with the times as the techniques have been passed down from one generation to the next. It has produced shrine and temple carvings, ranma, transom carvings, shishigashira, lion heads, tenjin-sama, statues of the defied famous educator, screens, panels, and ornaments. Still now, the sound of chisels can be heard in Inami. The same sound that was heard at the beginning of the town's wood carving history.